Mrs. Meyer, and today I'm going to teach the students in the third grade class how these travel. The objective of this lesson is students will be able to categorize these based on how they travel. The material used will be various types of speed, paper, and pencil. The procedure of the lesson is going to be as follows. I'm going to give each of the students a pile of seeds. They're going to say yes. Apple seeds, flax seeds, honeycomb, and acorn. I'm going to tell the students to work as a group to come up with a way of grouping your seeds. I'm the teacher. I'm going to circulate the classroom as the group of students work together. I'm going to split the class into two parts. So, I'm going to guide the group to look at the shape, the size, the color, and the final group of students from. If the group finishes early, I'm going to have to try to split the seeds and group them a different way. Once the group has gotten their seeds sorted, they're going to come back together as a group and have groups share their categories. So, for example, if the students get a group of seeds with apple seeds, they're going to explain the class, the size, the color, the shape, and how they travel. If they're going to get a squash, they're going to talk about the size, the shape, the color, and then discuss how they travel, the same with the pineapples and the acorn. I'm going to show the class categories of seeds sorted according to how they travel. So let's look over here. How does the seed move? So on the board, I'm going to explain to students. Seeds move by animals. So for example, birds, they eat the fruit. And then seeds come out and they're dropping. The wind is another important way for the seeds to move. We know helicopters have wings. Dandelion seeds are called parachutes. And how do they move? The ants bury them on the ground, and that's how they move. We have water. So if we go to tropical south in Florida, we can find coconuts. And the way coconuts be traveling through the water. So coconuts float for miles and miles until being dry land protected by special fibers on the seas. Oh, let's go rattle. This is another way of seas moving. Some plants gather seeds without help by bursting or rattling to make the seeds fall out. And then we have the flowers that we can find in our backyard. Flowers have a pile of seeds, birds, or moths. They take with them to another flower and create grape and nectar out of it. And the flower uses its pollen to create seeds, and the seeds grow inside a fruit. So, some plants grow in other ways, like the bulbs and the spores and suckers. They grow in all different types of ways. So, I'm going to show the class on the smart board a game or something that they can look at to learn